Good morning, students. Next, we are going to see this problem number 3 from exercise 2.6. Okay, up and the Cartesian form of the locus z is equal to x plus iy. If real part of I is z the whole square equal to 3, and second problem is imaginary part of 1 minus I the whole into z plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so now we are going to solve this problem first. See, first, I'm going to substitute z is equal to x plus iy, which I have given you already. And in Cartesian form is nothing but the answer should be in x and y alone. Okay, that should not be z there. Okay, so your answer must be in x, y, that is called Cartesian form. And now I'm going to substitute z as x plus iy. Okay, so now I have taken what they have given us, real part of iz the whole square equal to 3. Since they have given some value, I cannot consider these and all. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is real part of I into z is x plus iy. Okay, the whole square equal to 3. And now I'm just going to multiply the same I inside, so I'll be getting real part of ix minus y the whole square is equal to 3. And the real part of this is, see, I comes means it's an imaginary part, and this is my real part, and this is my y square minus y square. Okay, real part of ix minus y is minus y, and here I have this whole square on the outer side, so I'll be getting equal to 3. And finally, my answer is y square is equal to 3, and this is my Cartesian form. See, they have asked you the Cartesian form, not the value of y. Okay, so I am giving as such. And next is imaginary part of 1 minus I go into z plus 1 equal to 0. So here the same thing I am going to do. Before that I am going to consider, see, I have two things. So I am going to change this into a Cartesian form, then I will find the imaginary value. Okay, so first I am going to consider the values in the bracket, that is 1 minus I z plus 1. Okay, so I consider 1 minus I z is replaced by x plus iy plus 1. Just I am going to multiply, so as usual. Okay, so x plus iy minus ix, okay, minus ix plus y plus 1. So I am going to group this into a real and imaginary part. My real part is x plus y plus 1. Since the value which I have drawn, don't have I, is for real part, and now this term, that is y minus x, is my imaginary part. Okay, so they have given you imaginary part of 1 minus I z plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so next is, so I am going to substitute, that is imaginary part of x plus y plus 1